If you're tired of gambling your shards to Kadala, then I have a simple and straightforward solution for you. In this video, specifically for new players, I'll show you how to spend your soul shards fast and salvage all the inventory in 1 second. Let's get started. Hello and welcome back to my channel, Firzj here. Right now on your screen you see AutoHotKey tool. This is what we will need to make one simple macro to gamble and salvage all the items. This comes in handy especially when you have a regular mouse which doesn't support macro commands on hardware or software levels. But if you have, for example, a Firzj or Razer mouse, you can skip this part as they have official tools to record and save macros to onboard memory. And before you ask me in the comments, yes, it is absolutely safe to use it in the game like Diablo. I've been using macro commands since 2015 for salvaging gear, playing Star Pact Viz, and gambling shards for red speeds. So back to AutoHotKey. This is where we are going to write scripts or, generally speaking, macro commands. It can do pretty much anything: infinite key pressing, mouse pointing, pixel detection, or doing key combinations all at once. Anyway, let's download and install AutoHotKey from the official website. The link can also be found in the description. Now create a new AutoHotKey script in any desired place. Open it with any text editor like Notepad or VS Code and type the lines as follows. You can later customize your keys for your personal preferences. Hashtag if win active Diablo 3. This line will force your script to work only in a certain window without interfering other apps. In the next line we create a key which we will press to activate our macro. I'll use H as an example. You may also include a combination of keys to start your script simply by adding plus, which stands for shift, or circumflex, which stands for control, before your key. First line H double colon and hit enter to the next line. You may also write a comment after semicolon to make your code more readable. We create a loop and set the amount of 30 to repeat right mouse click 30 times to fully fill your inventory with items. Create braces and type mouse click comma right. On the next line you may also include a simple notification sound once this script finishes its job. For this case, I use Windows exclamation sound. If you don't need a sound effect, you can ignore this step and close braces. And then add return function to end the execution for each separate macro. Now it is time to test our script in the game. Save the file and then double click on it. It should then appear next to your clock in the system tray. After you enter the game, go to Kadala, hover over any item you wish to buy and use the key you specified in the script. If you have enough blood shards, it should start gambling immediately and then play a sound once it's finished. In case you want a different script, here's another less elegant solution to gambling. If you want to gamble less items and with specified keys, then you can use this script instead. Simply type any key for activation, double colon, then in the next line type mouse click, right, and repeat this line as many times as you need. The script will gamble items depending on the number of lines you put inside. In my case, it will gamble only 5 items and stop. Moving next for instant salvaging. Once we gambled enough and our inventory is now piled with many yellows or blues, we can create a different macro to salvage all that stuff without pointing our mouse and doing it manually each time. Since there is no hotkey to salvage all gear, we will have to use mouse coordinates to navigate to these 3 buttons. Let's create a new key that we will use to salvage our gear. Keep in mind that depending on your screen resolution, these coordinates may differ. Similar to previous script, we type mouse click left and enter specified coordinates. For a standard 1080p resolution, I'll use these numbers. These coordinates will point the mouse cursor directly to the gray salvaging button. On the next line, we create send command and type enter inside braces for confirmation. Same steps for the other 2 buttons. Mouse click left, add coordinates, and then send enter command. You can also include sleep function in milliseconds to add a small delay to avoid possible input lag or misclicks. If you have a different screen resolution, you can find and enter your specific coordinates by opening Windows Pi. You can find this tool by right-clicking AutoHotKey icon from the system tray. In this window, you'll see your precise mouse coordinates, so simply point your mouse to the required button in the game and write down screen coordinates from the mouse position window. And then simply simply replace it to your coordinates with the comma and save. Once it is all done, test your script in the game. If your script is still running in the background, you can close the process from the system tray or reload the current script to apply changes without restarting. If your script misclicks the salvaging buttons, then you should fix your coordinates with the help of Windows Pi. Keep in mind that if you change your resolution or drag the game window, it may not work properly. Now for the gaming mice. This process is way simpler and shorter than writing your own AutoHotKey script. Most gaming mice have an official piece of software to record and save macro, and for this demonstration I will use Razer Mouse with Synapse app. As simple as it sounds, you can navigate to Macro tab, create a new macro, select additional options, record your input and save. You can then assign this macro to any mouse button and create a profile for a specific game. And that is all for now. I hope you found this video useful and you can now gamble almost instantly and salvage all unnecessary items with just one click. If you have some questions, leave a comment below and also subscribe to my channel to support my work. Thank you for watching and listening. Have a nice day and stay safe.